Okay, so in this quick video, I'm going to talk about adding records in TYPO3. Now, records are widely used within TYPO3 for any kind of content that has a kind of repetitive nature. So things which you may wish to display with a consistent layout. So the most obvious example of this is kind of a blog post or a news story. But other examples might include team members or case studies, maybe addresses or offices, that kind of thing. So there's no limit to the ways in which records can be used. For today's tutorial, I'm going to be using the Liquid Light site. So if I just jump into the back end of the Liquid Light site, you'll see that we've got our page structure here. At the bottom, and this goes for all of the Liquid Light sites and probably most TYPO3 configurations, you will have a resources folder in the page tree. And when we expand that resources folder, you can see the different record types that we're using. Now on Liquid Light, we're not using anything like the full functionality that's available with TYPO3. So we've just got a few different catalogs in place. We use slides, so this might be for large image-based sliders that appear around the site. So each slide would be a record. We've also got case studies. So this allows us to display our recent projects. And because we're using records for it, they follow a consistent layout. And it also enables things like filtering and categorization. What I'm going to focus on today is mainly the blog area. So these are our news stories and blog posts. And as I said before, this is all because we want those to follow a consistent layout. So if I click into blog, then what it's going to do is it's going to prompt me at this point to switch into list view. Now, if you've watched any of our other tutorials, you'll know that 90% of the time when you're editing in TYPO3, you're going to be using page view mode. And this time we want to be in list mode. So you can either click switch to list mode here, or you can use list mode on the left-hand side here. So once I go into list mode, what we're actually presented with here is this is the list of records. So this is all of our blog posts, published or otherwise. Okay, so for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a new record within here, which is easily done by clicking this plus icon. And then what you'll be presented with is essentially an online form which you work through and complete, and by the time you've completed all of the options, you will have finished adding a record. Different records will ask different questions and have different fields for you to fill in, and that's one of the beauties of adding records, that you're not expected to handle any kind of layout at this point. You're just compiling the information needed for the record, in this case a blog post, and then using different templates, we can actually display that content in different ways. So as we scroll down, the first thing that's most important is to add a title. So there we go. And the abstract is a completely optional part of the process because it will pull in from the main content. But for this, I will add an abstract. And then we've got our main content. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to use some dummy text. Okay, so I've put some dummy text in there. Maybe I'll just add a few paragraph breaks. There we go. And that is the basic structure. So what I've done there is I've added a page of text with some with a title and with an abstract. So in its most basic sense, that is the record. What I can also do is I can go across these tabs at the top and add further information. So it's not uncommon that in a blog post, we would want to add an author, or we can use the related users. We can also add relations, so this is the categorization, so perhaps this is about me musing, or it's a TYPO3 tutorial. Obviously, I can choose as many of the categories as I want. This will differ from different TYPO3 sites, so it's important that you understand how your specific site has been put together. You may have a completely different set of categories available to yourself. And within the relations field, we can also add a related image. And I'm just going to go, once I click add image, it's going to open the file manager. And I can come in here and I'm just going to choose a random image from this blog folder. So that's added a related image there. I can also add the alt tag to the image. Always important to have alt tags. And it's within this related tab that I can also add related news articles. Now again, this will depend on the configuration of your own TYPO3 site, but this is an option. And if it's not something that's available on your install, then you can always talk to your system administrator to see if it's functionality that could be added for you. And on our site, we do actually use the related news. So I can come into here and I can come down to my resources folder, click on the blog, and then it will show me all of these different records, and I could click this plus on any that are relevant to the topic I'm discussing, and you can see it's automatically added them in there. Similarly, our default news kind of catalog allows for files to be related to a blog post. So perhaps there's an additional PDF document that you want to link to, that's where you can add that there. So that is, in its most basic sense, how you add a news record in TYPO3. This is obviously the blog that I've focused on. If you were adding records for different things, different catalog models, then of course the options presented to you will be different, but the basic structure of how we've done this will be the same. So once I'm happy with all the information I've added, then I can save and close. And you can see that it's taken me back to the list of records, and there is my new blog post that we've created together. You can see it's got this red circle on the icon here. This means that it is hidden, and so it won't be live until I want it to be live. If I go back and edit it again, then I can actually do save and view page. And this will allow me to preview the post before it goes live. So here you can see that we've got our image. This is the default image placement on the Liquid Light site. This may differ on a different TYPO3 site, but this is how we've set our news template to behave. We've got our content, which I've added in. You can see below the content, we've got our categories, which I added in the related tab. And beneath that, our related posts. So once you've reviewed it and you're happy for it to go live, we can go back to the back end. Again, we can close this. And then all I would do is I would click the unhide record, and that would publish that news post and it would go live. Okay, so that's just a quick introduction to adding records in TYPO3. I hope you found that helpful, and check back in soon for more TYPO3 content. Thanks for watching.